Senhoras e senhores, continuamos o nono encontro internacional de direitos culturais, agora com a presença da professora Benedetta Ubertazzi, que é professora lombarda, professora da Universidade de Milão Bicocca, uma grande especialista em propriedade intelectual e que se dedica muito como consultora ad hoc da Unesco às questões do patrimônio cultural e material. A professora Benedetta Ubertazzi vai nos brindar com uma palestra sobre uma província e uma cidade muito interessantes para o campo cultural, que é Cremona, a cidade dos violinos. Professora Benedetta, muito obrigado por sua presença e a palavra é sua.
Grazie mille, professor Umberto Cugna, grazie mille, Umberto. Per me è un grandissimo piacere essere qui con voi, parlo in italiano adesso, ma poi cambierò e parlerò in inglese durante la presentazione. Il mio piacere è veramente forte e spero presto di poter essere in Brasile fisicamente da voi. È veramente il mio sogno, Umberto lo sa, perché quando è venuto a Milano tutti i giorni gli dicevo ti prego, portami in Brasile. E io l'ho portato Umberto invece a Cremona. E ecco, questo Umberto, dobbiamo condividere la fotografia dove tu sei all'entrata della città di Cremona. Ah. Quando si arriva con il treno c'è subito un violino, una scultura di acciaio di un violino, e abbiamo fatto subito una foto lì perché Cremona è proprio la città dei violini. Quindi okay. Adesso, se voi siete d'accordo, parlo in inglese. So we are going to talk today about cultural rights and in particular the impact of the pandemic. And we will focus on traditional violin craftsmanship in Cremona. And I'm talking in my personal capacity, being a UNESCO facilitator, but at the same time, I am a legal advisor for the municipality of Cremona. So this is why I can talk to you about the situation in Cremona in the way in which I will present today. So Cremona is a city and a municipality in Lombardy, in Italy, in the north part of Italy. And the population is of approximately 75,000 people, and of which 150 are violin makers. So a big number of violin makers are based in Cremona, and not all of them are Italian, rather the opposite. A great majority of violin makers are not Italians, but are based in Cremona to practice their tradition. So according to the latest World Bank data, Italy's annual export of bowed string instrument is worth 6.6 million, mainly to Japan, the United States, Hong Kong and China. And Cremona alone contributes about 80%, or more than 5 million a year, to this total. So you can see the great majority of bowed string instruments in Italy is made in Cremona. So why are we talking about Cremona when we have to talk about the pandemic? Because Cremona was hit the hardest by the COVID-19 outbreak in Italy. The hospital in Cremona was the hardest hit in all of Italy's north, with all the beds taken up by patients infected by the virus, all the beds. The second hospital in Europe to be hit by COVID-19, of course, first wave, because now we're going to see what's happening. The hospital was the subject of the frontline documentary Inside Italy's COVID War. So 6,577 cases of COVID-19 in Cremona as of 21 of June 2020, 391% increase in deaths in March compared with the 2015-2019 average. There is ongoing debate as to why Cremona was so heavily impacted by the pandemic. So there are claims that environmental conditions such as air pollution, led to the speed of the spread. So researchers say 10 times quicker than usual. On the other hand, researchers and scientists argue that agriculture and livestock mass farming were responsible, because Cremona is also the location where a lot of industrialized farming is occurring, and the food is great in Cremona, but the outcome of the coin, the other side of the coin, may be that this facilitated air pollution and therefore this spread of the virus. Traditional violin craftsmanship in Cremona is the title of the element that was inscribed in 2012 during the 7th committee on the representative list of the intangible cultural heritage of humanity. So what is the heritage? Cremona's craftsmen are internationally renowned for the unique process they use to create violins, violas, cellos, and double basses. Even if we know that the ICH convention is not based on concepts such as exclusivity, uniqueness, here we have something that is also unique. Every part of the instrument is made with a specific, carefully selected, and naturally well-seasoned piece of wood. Craftsmanship requires a high level of creativity. Each instrument is individual and adapted to the general use and personal knowledge of the craftsperson. So safeguarding the element is governed by the municipality of Cremona. The trademark Cremona Liuteria has been registered to protect this heritage. This is a collective trademark, and the trademark regulation specifies that trademarked violins can only be made by violin makers that have produced violins in Cremona for 5 years. So as safeguarding measures, they are using a trademark. So Cremona, the pandemic, and UNESCO. UNESCO has been keen to engage with Cremona's experience of the COVID-19 pandemic. Traditional violin making in Cremona has been selected from over 200 contributions from 87 countries by UNESCO to be featured at the 8th session of General Assembly of the 2003 Convention for the Safeguarding of ICH, which took place from the 9th to the 11th of September 2020. Cremona, in that particular event, the General Assembly, was one of the 5 communities selected. So there was Cremona, then a community from Peru, another for Latin America, another community from Sri Lanka for Asia, and then for Africa, Mali, Cremona for Europe, and for the Arab states, Palestine, a community from Palestine. You can listen to the meeting because it's in YouTube. And during this event, the UNESCO Secretariat held an online dialogue session on living heritage experiences and the COVID pandemic. And the event showed some of the inspiring experiences collected from different regions, as I told you. And the experience of Cremona and its community of luthiers during the COVID-19 pandemic has also been presented at the 14th annual meeting of the Southeast European Experts Network on Intangible Cultural Heritage, a UNESCO meeting, and the 4th roundtable related to the safeguarding of ICH, organized by the Regional Center for the Safeguarding of ICH in Southeastern Europe under the auspices of UNESCO in Sofia. So in particular, if we focus on public spaces and cultural heritage during the pandemic, we can say that violin making is integral to Cremona and is considered the international cradle of violin making. Cremonese violin makers were directly impacted by the pandemic, of course. Ordinarily, each violin maker constructs from 3 to 6 instruments per year, usually 3, more 3 than 6, from their laboratories. And due to the lockdown measures, winemakers were prevented not only from selling, but also from entering their laboratories, and therefore from continuing their practice. And if you think that in 1 year they can produce only typically three instruments, you may understand that the lockdown was at least one quarter of a year, and still we have to see what is going to happen, even more than one quarter, probably one third. And of course, so they can produce probably one violin this year, even not probably. COVID-19 led to the closure of cultural institutions and public spaces that are really closed to this practice. So, for instance, the closures included museums, which form part of the Cremonese community as the guardians of knowledge and intangible know-how. So the museum is very important. We are going to see later in my presentation what is the role of the Violin Museum in Cremona for violin makers, not for tourists, but for violin makers themselves. So the closure of the museum was a disaster for them. Due to COVID-19, there has been an unprecedented shift of cultural consumption from offline to online, of course. So safeguarding measures during the pandemic. The emergency phase of the pandemic required immediate measures to facilitate the continued production of traditional violins. So intensification of collaboration with social networks, with virtual broadcasts, promotional videos dedicated to the deserted city of Cremona, and special hearing on Easter Sunday in the museum. We are going to talk about some of these. So the resilience of cultural heritage in the face of COVID. So among the different initiatives, there was this performance of Lena Yokohama. We can listen to this at the end of my presentation because it's really touching, on the roof of the hospital in Cremona. And this performance was a very strong symbolism related to Cremona's resilient response to COVID-19 and was viewed across the world, becoming a powerful reminder of resilience and hope in times of crisis. Parts of the video were used by the well-known Italian confectionery brand Barilla in their latest commercial. And the video was also featured on Japanese state TV during a special on COVID. Proceeds from the transfer of copyright were donated to the United Onlus for Cremona. And this video, once again, is an example of the importance of violin making in Cremona. All the actors involved in the production of this video have been collaborating in Cremona on a regular basis for a long time. So the violinist, Pro Cremona, a young collective aimed at promoting the local area, and the Museum of Violin, the municipal police, and other actors. So there was really a network of stakeholders collaborating together to safeguard the heritage during the pandemic. Several initiatives and campaigns were introduced in response to the closure of museums, enabling communities to adapt and remain resilient. So for instance, UNESCO, supported by ICOM, assessed the impact of the pandemic on the museum sector. The Network of European Museum Organizations carried out a survey to discern how COVID has impacted museum budgets and operations. In Cremona, in particular, the Museum of Violin Foundation responded to the closure with intensified social networks and training programs. Teaching materials were distributed to music teachers to be used for virtual lessons and producing videos. And once again, as I said, on Easter Sunday in the deserted Arvedi Auditorium in the Museum of Violin in Cremona, the regional broadcaster was used to transmit a special hearing with the Stradivari violin, a Cremonese symbol of the city, dedicated to all citizens. So thank you so much for listening. Now, if I still have like 2 minutes, we can listen together to the performance of Lena Jokolama.
Bravissimo.
Okay. Sorry, but it's really very touching this every time I go like that. Okay, so
I thank you very again. Much.
It's okay. Where are you?
I'm here. You cannot see me because your computer is showing something, but if you end the sharing screen, you can see me.
Yes, no, I can see you. Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for this amazing presentation and touching presentation. And Cremona is very important to compare with our cities here because Cremona offers equipment to other cities that produce instruments, musical instruments, including a city here in my state called Guaramiranga. They have a luthery. And they buy the instruments to produce the musical instruments in Cremona. It's very, very important, like, this experience. Thank you very much, Benedetta.
Thank you very much. And come back soon to Cremona to visit us, Umberto, and stay strong and resilient in face of the pandemic, okay, you all. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. And in a few minutes, we will ask you to answer some questions from our public, okay?
Okay. Thank you. Okay,
thank
bye
you
bye.
Very much.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Thank you.